सब्सक्राइब कीजिए नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजी और एजुकेशनल वीडियोस सबसे पहले देखने के लिए। हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू अवर नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल एंड आई एम योर फ्रेंड विकास नेहरा हेयर। फ्रेंड्स, एज आई हैव प्रोमिस्ड यू इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियोज दैट आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ सीरीज ऑफ वीडियोज ऑन सेल स्क्रिप्टिंग स्पेशली फॉर बिगनर्स एंड एट दैट टाइम आई हैव क्रिएटेड अ प्लेलिस्ट इन माई चैनल for the same. So from today onwards, I'm going to start this series of videos on cell scripting, and in today's session I will take the introduction of cell scripting. Actually, before starting this session, we must know what is shell. So a Unix shell is a computer program which interprets user commands either directly entered through the keyboard by the users or can be read from the file called the script. Sometimes we often feel that the terminal is the shell, but it is not actually true. Terminal on any Unix-like system is not a shell in itself, but it allows the user to use the different shells depending on his or her choice. In today's session, I will first tell you what is a shell, how it is different from the terminal, what are the different shells that are available in our OS, how can we install the additional shells, how can we know which shell we are currently using, how can we change the shell, and after that I will simply create a bash script program and I will show you how can you execute it. So without wasting our time, let's get started. If you will log in any Linux or Unix-like machine on GUI, then you will find a program with the name as terminal there. So this program is actually allow us to use the system through command line interface. So sometimes we feel that this terminal is the shell, but it is not actually true. This terminal allows us to run the commands, but it can use different shells depending on our choice. So here on this terminal, if I will run this echo dollar shell command, so it will show me the current shell which the terminal is using. So it is currently using /bin/ksh. It is the corn shell. So if I will simply mention bash here and press enter, then you will find that now it is also showing the details of the username and the machine host name. And again, if I will execute the echo dollar shell command, then it will show me the current shell, that is /bin/bash. So actually we are using the different shells on the same terminal. So terminal is actually not the same as the shell. Terminal allows us to use the different shells. It is actually a program which is there to use the system through command line interface. So shells are different, terminal is the different thing. So now let me show you, if I have an additional program on my host machine like PuTTY or MobiXterm from where I can log in into my machine. So here I have logged in from my host machine. This is the MobiXterm. I'm using this because it gives a better display. So here, if I run the echo dollar shell command, echo dollar shell, not hash. Different shells provides different options. So it will show me the current shell as KSH or the corn shell. So echo dollar shell command is used to check which shell we are currently using. If I will mention bash here, then we have changed the shell to /bin/bash. So if I will run the echo dollar shell command again, then it is giving me the output as /bin/bash. We are using bash shell right now. Earlier we were using the corn shell. Now how will we know that what are the different shells that are available on our OS? So to check the available shells on our machine, we can simply run cat etc shells command. This command shows us the different shells that are currently available on our machine. So the first shell is /bin/sh. This is the born shell. It is the original shell that is there in almost all Unix-like systems. It is the traditional and the oldest shell which is still in use on Linux or the Unix-like machines. Then you will find this /bin/bash. Actually, after the sh, this born again shell was reinvented. It is the improved version of sh, and it is the standard GNU shell which is intuitive and flexible. It is most widely used in Unix like systems, including the Macintosh and nowadays in Windows 10 also. So it is the most popular shell that we use. You will also find shells like zsh, ksh. Ksh is the corn shell, which is named after the David Corn, who invented it in 1980s. And you will find the tchs. Actually, this is the C shell. So there are different shells. And if you want to install some additional shells, you can actually install them from the local YUM repository or from the internet very easily. Now, how will you know that? How can you change the shell? So, as I have done earlier we were using the ksh shell. Let me show one more time. And if I want to change it, I can simply mention the shell name like this. So with this, I can change the shell, or we can execute the chsh command to change the shell. Now you have to mention the new shell name and press enter. If we need to know the location of any shell in our system, or if we want to know the exact path, we can execute which command, and after the which command, we need to mention the name of the shell like this. So the location of bash shell is inside /usr/bin. In the similar fashion, we can check the location of other shells in our system. So sh shell is also inside usr/bin. So shells are the programs which interprets the user commands, either directly entered through the keyboard by the user, or can be read from the file called the script. So what are the scripts? Scripts are the files which are used by the shell to interpret the commands. If you will have a look at the available shells in your system, you will find these two shells already available in most of the Linux machines. And these shells are born shell and born again shell. And out of these two shells, the born again shell or the bash shell is the most widely used shell, and the scripting done on this shell is known as the bash scripting as well as the bash shell scripting. Now, if we need to create and execute any script, we have to keep in mind that we don't need to compile the script in order to execute it, because the shell scripts are interpreted by the operating systems but not compiled. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to create a simple bash script, and after that I will show you how can we execute it. And in that script we are going to use the quotes. So let me first tell you what are the quotes. If we mention anything after the echo command, that gets printed on the terminal. And if we mention anything inside the inverted commas like this, so that gets printed exactly as it is mentioned in the command. We can use either the single quote or the double quotes. depending on the requirements. Like this, whatever we will mention, that will get printed on the terminal. But in case if we use the variable inside the quotes, then we need, then it depends on our choice which type of quote we want to use. So let me show you. Let me set a variable first. Let us say my var is a variable which contains the value as 555. Now if you will run echo dollar my var, so it will print the result as 555, like this. Why? Because we have set this variable already. Now if you will execute the command echo dollar my var, so you will find the result as 555, as I have already shown you. But if you will mention this my var inside single quotes, then you will get the result as my var only. And if you will mention this inside the double quotes, then you will get the actual result, that is 555. So this is the difference between the single quote and the double quote. Inside single quote, whatever we will mention, that will get printed as it is on the screen. But if we will use the double quotes, then it will print the actual value of the variable. So this was the basic difference between the two. And in the similar fashion, we can use echo option hyphen E, and we can mention, for example, welcome to Nehra classes. So here, if we will press the enter, then it will be printed on the screen as it is. But if we will mention here the new line character like this, then the Nehra classes will be printed in the next line like this. And if we will use the tab key option here, then it will insert the additional space between the two, between the two words. So these are the available options which we can use with the echo. So echo is the quotes. Now with this echo, we will create a simple script. Now I'm going to create a script with the touch command. So with this touch command, I have created a file with the name as helloworld.sh in my home directory. And here I have mentioned the extension as .sh because it helps the other users to know that this file is a script. And it also helps the system, especially the file editors, to understand the type of file, that this file is a script, and the editors display this file in a better way. So if you don't write the extension after the script, then it is all right. It will not create any problems, but it is always good if you use the extension after the name of the script. So if you will list the contents with the ls-alh command, and you will have a look at the permissions of this file helloworld.sh, you will find that it is having the read-write permission for the owner, only read permission for the group, and only read permission for the others. Now I'm going to edit this file. You can use your own favorite file editor like Nano or gedit or vi editor. I'm going to use the vi editor here, and here I'm going to write the script. So before writing the script, in the first line we mention the hash, and after the hash we mention the bank symbol, so it is also known as the hash bank. After this hash bank, we mention the name of the shell which the script will use. So I will write here /bin/bash. Actually this line tells the system which shell the execution of this script will take. It is just to let the system know about the shell which will be used by this script. So after this hash bang, mention the name of the script, and after that we can write our script. So let me write our first script, echo hello world. So this is our first script which we are going to execute. After that, we have to save this file. Now we have written the first script. To execute the script, we need to run this by using this symbol dot forward slash and mention the name hello world dot sh and press enter. So if you will press enter, you will find that it is giving an error, permission denied, and that is why I was wanting to show this error to you. Why it is showing this error? Because there is no execute permission set on this script. That is why it is giving this error. Let me again show you. So have a look at the permissions again. You will find no execute permission on this file, and that is why we are not able to execute it. So to set the execute permission on this script file, we can use chmod command. Chmod plus x and the name of the file. Either we can use this option or we can use chmod and set the permission individually for the owner, group and the others like this. Now if you will check the permissions again, this time you will find that the permissions have been changed, and now the execute permission is also available there for each and everyone. Now we have set the permission, so we can simply run this or we can execute it hello world dot sh, and this will give you the result after the execution. So guys, you can see that we have successfully created and executed our first script, and that's it from the today's session. Hope you guys would have enjoyed the session. If you like it, then do share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you are new on our channel, then subscribe us and turn on the bell notification. We will upload more videos in the upcoming days on the Shell scripting. So keep yourself tuned in for more videos. See you in the next session. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind. Vande Mataram.